here with at Foreign Faces.
Hey guys, what's up now? This is my chair sister, Jasmine. This is my baby. She's turning 18 today. And we have a little makeup tutorial for y'all. It's a Cut-Crease, glitter Cut-Crease. If you would like to achieve this look, stay tuned. What's up, dimes? Welcome back to my channel. We're gonna get right into it. So I am shaping her brows with the NYX pencil in the shade dark brown. And then I'm going to go over her brows with the LAX Girl pomade. Yes, get you that pomade, it is bomb. Scooping out her brows, you know, just filling everything in that's sparse. I try to shape the brows according to the way her hair is growing. So like, I don't really like changing up the brows. I want to give you the natural brow shape that you have, and we just want to fill that out and highlight that. Spooling out her brows with the LAX Girl Tinted Brow Mascara, and then I want to use my Real Technique Concealer Brush to clean under her brows with the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Medium Beige on the bottom, and then on the top we want to go over that with the shade Fawn, or you could also use the shade Toffee. You most likely mix both of them. So I like to start by cleaning her brows from the front of her brow instead of her arch. Most makeup artists like to get the arch first, but doing this helps me, it guides me to getting the perfect brow. And then you see me cleaning up the top of her eyebrows with the mixture of Fawn and Toffee. So you just want to go ahead and buff all of that out into her skin. You don't want to leave the concealer in one place because it's going to get hard over time. So you want to just buff all of that out into her skin so everything has a nice and flawless blend. So now I think I'm satisfied with how her brows look. We're going to move on to the eyeshadow. I went ahead and primed her lids with the same concealer we used to clean under her brows, medium beige. And as you can see, she has individuals on, so I had to put some tape on that to hold it down. Most makeup artists do not like when you have individuals before your appointment. It gets in the way, as you can see, but we are going to make it work. So I went ahead and started my transition colors off camera with the Morphe Dare to Create palette. We're working with the nudes because we want to highlight the gold. So just applying all that brown into her crease to intensify our cut crease. Now I'm going in with my makeup remover on this Q-tip to remove the excess eyeshadows on her lids. I want her cut crease to be extremely sharp. And now you see me cutting her crease with the P. Louise base. If you do not have it, go get it because it is bomb. So the trick to getting the cut crease is not dragging it out. You want to tap this product on her lids to slowly create the sharp circle that you want, and then slowly start dragging it up to build the full cut crease. I'm going to allow the video to just play because I want it to be in real time so you guys could see how long I take to make my cut crease, how precise it gets. All you really need for this part is patience. So I'm just going back in to clean up this cut crease, make it as precise as I can. And then what you want to do is you want to start to buff out the product on her lids. Cleaning up the concealer by bringing back in those brown shades just so we do not have a harsh transition. And then we want to go ahead and start placing our pigments. First, I'm starting with this white MAC pigment. in the corner of her eye. I am using a very detailed round brush to get on her crease. And this pigment is very pigmented, as you can see. And what I wanted to do was lay the pigments on first before we lay our glitters to give us a full effect. Now going in with our gold shimmer, it's a very light gold pigment in the middle of her crease. And as you can see, this is building up very nicely. Her boyfriend was there talking to me in the back. He was like, ooh, I was like, I know you like. Going back in to blend and buff everything together so there are no harsh pigments and everything is just perfectly blended now. So now I want to go ahead and apply my glitter base. This is NYX Glitter Primer. It's a very affordable primer. You could find it at the beauty supply store and it works wonders for me. So I'm just letting it lay on the lids and going in with our first glitter. This is chunky glitter from Lux Glam Cosmetics. All of their glitters are bomb and very affordable. So go ahead and get you some, boo. So y'all see how it's popping? It is popping already. So just laying all of this glitter on her lids because it is a glitter cut crease. Going back in and back and forth. Our eyes are almost done. So now I'm coming back into her crease with a darker brown to blend everything out. And yeah, it's looking bomb. So now I am placing my favorite shimmer in the middle of her eye. This is the white pigment shimmer from L'Oreal Cosmetics, I believe. And now I'm just buffing everything out to complete this look, getting all that glitter off her face. She is feeling it. Oh, her boyfriend. She is feeling it. Coming in with my NYX liner. I definitely need a sponsor with them because all of my products are NYX. So just drawing on this liner, as you can see. I was going for cat eye, but it comes out the way it comes out. I think it looked bomb though. So now I'm going over her liner with this neon liquid liner. Oh yes, yeah, it's notched. So any mistakes that I made with the green, I just went back in with my NYX liner to clean it up and shape everything out. So using a spoolie to get all the glitters off, and now we're pulling up the tape. I promise she was not hurt in the process of this. She barely even felt it. So her eyes are open. We're just getting all the glitters off and we're getting ready to beat this face, honey. Drying off this milk and magnesium on her skin, I promise you it's gonna be a matte finish and you're gonna look bomb. And I'm just hyping my stink up because it's her birthday. Hey, it's her birthday. Hey. Okay, so now we're gonna clean up this primer with Milan matte primer to clean up this milk and magnesium on her face and just to set and start for our foundation process. Her skin has gotten a little brighter since the last time I saw her because, you know, of course, the quarantine. So I had to find her shade and we finally found a perfect mixture. This is me laying it on with a brush and then we're gonna beat the face on a boom boom. So I'm just speeding through this process because it is the foundation routine. Y'all know what I'm doing. And as you can see, this is a tapping motion going on. You do not want to swipe your foundation across your skin. That's how you get pimples. That's just bad. Do not swipe. Just pat everything in until you like your finish. Stink says that's on period. So now we are concealing and highlighting under her eyes with the medium beige that I used to clean her brows. It's just her perfect tone. It has her undertones. And this is LA Girl Pro Concealer. Get you one, boo. So now y'all see me just highlighting everything that we need to highlight. And I'm just gonna let the video play because y'all know it's about to go quick. So I like to interchange my brushes when I am highlighting under the eyes because I want to get under your eyes. So I use the bigger brush to blend into your foundation and then the smaller brush to get under the eyes precise. Now setting under her eyes with ColourPop's translucent setting powder, and what you see me doing is tapping that product in. I don't like leaving it on because I just like this finish better, tapping in the product instead of just letting it sit on your face. It just leaves a better finish for me. I do it for myself, so I do it on my clients. So just buffing that in and using the smaller brush to get under her eyes. You want to make sure nothing is creasing. Now I am contouring with this black opal foundation stick. And it's just the perfect shade for her, not too dark, not too yellow. And you just see me buffing this up. When it comes to cream contour, you want to blend upwards and not downwards. Because if you blend downwards, she will have a mustache. So all you see me is moving this product up closer to her cheekbones just to emphasize and sharpen the look. Using the same brush we used for her contour to contour her nose as well, what you see me doing is patting on this foundation and not swiping. Going into my Morphe contour and bronze palette to get her shades for her blush and just to bring that highlight and contour to life. I am not swiping, gently patting on everything and blending it out as so. Spraying her face with my Morphe finish spray. Get you some, it is bomb. Blow drying, this look is almost done, y'all. I'm excited. Patting in everything after spraying just because we want everything to be set. And she's feeling it. She is feeling it. She is feeling it, and I'm just going in this time is a little more speed through because we're trying to get through this tutorial for y'all. Please let me know if y'all like tutorials this detailed, or you know, because I don't know how well y'all do your makeup. I just try my best to explain. And now I am putting on her highlights. She's getting bomb. She's getting cute. And we're almost done. My stink is so pretty. So, yeah. Finishing up the look. And I'm going to just let you guys watch. Woo! Like I said, this is the last part before I'm done with my clients. I go back under the eyes to finish this look. So I'm just bringing back the nude shades and the brown to intensify her waterline. I also put a white pencil in her waterline instead of black, and I think it has made the look. So just buffing everything out, blending in everything, and adding on her blush because my baby smiles. Spraying her face one more time. Getting her right. Getting my stink of right. I combed her. Ooh, sorry, stink. Ooh, she is bomb. She is bomb. That is on period. That's on period. Suck. Period. This is the finished look. I obviously off camera put on her lip because, you know, we was rushing. I didn't get to record that part, but this is the look and it is bomb. Please thumbs up this video, like and subscribe, share it to your friends, and I will see y'all next time. Peace.